वेलकम टू ज्ञान निकेतन गर्ल्स स्कूल। आई तन्नु श्रीवास्तव एक्सप्लेनिंग द टॉपिक वर्किंग विद टेबल। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न द प्रैक्टिकल विद द टेबल, हाउ टू इंसर्ट, हाउ टू डू द मॉडिफिकेशन एंड हाउ टू वर्क विद द टेबल। टू इंसर्ट द टेबल इन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट वर्ड, फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट वर्ड। व्हेन वी स्टार्ट द विंडो, the first bar is called the title bar, this is called the title bar, and these are called the tabs. Home, insert, menu, home, insert, page layout, these options you can see, this is called the layout. So we have to insert the table, we use the insert tab. We use the insert tab, it gives option to insert the table. When we click on the table option, we get option like this. This is called table grid. When you select as number of boxes on the screen, it will insert a table with the specified number of rows and columns. This is the first method. Another method you can see, go to the insert tab, table option, insert table. It gives us a dialog box. When we click on OK, you can see it will insert a specified number of rows and columns. Now we will see how to do the formatting with the table. When you go to the top left corner of the table, you will see four headed arrow. This arrow is called the table move handle. Clicking on that, entire table will be selected. And using that, we can apply all the formatting feature for all rows and columns. Look, using this option, we can move our table from one place to another place in the top left corner. Now we will come to the right corner. You will see small square at the bottom of the table in the right corner. Look it. When we move mouse pointer to that, When we move mouse pointer to that corner, you can see double headed arrow. Clicking on that, you can see we can resize the table. Hold it, hold the double headed arrow and move upward or downward to resize the table. This is called resizing the table. Now we will see the different option to resize the table. Auto fit. When auto fit option is given with the layout tab, these are also used to resize the table. Using the auto fit contain, you will suppose you are writing contain with the cell. Look. And content is not adjusted with the cell. Then according to the content, you will see it is automatically adjusted. Look, when the column width is not changed, the text comes automatically to the next line. This is called fixed column width and this process is called wrap text. This process is called wrap text. You will get also two options, auto fit to content. Using that, the column width will be automatically changed like this. And next was, on next is auto fit window. It adjusts the column width according to the data elements, according to the data entered. Now we will learn how to insert rows and columns. Look, when we have to insert rows and columns, we select first rows, we select first column, or we select the row. When we are working with row, we have to select insert above and below. Because it is the horizontal line, we have to select above and below. When we are working with column like this, we have to select the column. When we are working with the column, it is the vertical line. So we have to select left or right. This option you will get in the layout tab. You can see insert above and below used for the row. And left and right used for the column. To insert the row and column, first we have to select it. We select the row and column using the left mouse button and clicking on left option, it will insert a column before the column in the left side, and using the insert right, you can see it has inserted the column in the right side. Same thing we have to do for the row. Select the row. Clicking on above will insert one row above the row with the selected row, and clicking on below will insert the row below the row. Now we will see split cell and the merge cell. Merge cell is used to combine multiple cells in a single cell. Suppose all the cells are selected. Clicking on merge, it will display all the cells. It will display a single cell instead of multiple cells. This is called merge cell. Clear? Now we will see the split cell. Split cell, that means divide a single cell into multiple cells. Suppose this is the single cell, we have to split it. Then clicking on the split cell will give you a dialog box to specify in how many parts you want to divide the cell. Clicking on that will divide the cell. This is called split cell. Thank you.